So Swami wants a chance to come in and respond before I end this discussion.
I am not saying that Sadiq Basha is valueless. I was only saying that Mr. Krishna Anand, in his usual way, said that this is a huge setback. It's not a huge setback, because all investigations where so many brains are involved, so many agencies are involved, so many institutions are involved, we can always find alternative ways of solving a criminal or a crime. So therefore, it is a setback, but it's not a huge setback.
It's a setback,
that's all
but
I
it's
said.
Not a huge setback. Chandan Mitra, do you believe on the basis which the CBI has proceeded so far, the people of India have reason to believe that they're going after the right people and the truth will emerge? Or do you think the mighty and the powerful, because they are involved and guilty, will get away?
Well, you see, one cannot have absolutely full confidence in the CBI, because it is subject, as we have seen many times, subject to political pressures, and pressures from the ruling party, we know, is not averse to using the CBI to kind of tailor their inquiry. But in this particular case, because the Supreme Court is monitoring the entire matter, there is some greater degree of confidence. We believe that the Supreme Court has given the appropriate directions, and the CBI, because it's being monitored by the Supreme Court, I think so far, by the looks of it, it seems it's conducting a fair inquiry. And therefore, it was obviously zeroing in on something, which is why I think Mr. Sadiq Basha's deposition in Delhi today would have been crucial. As your panelists are saying, he may have turned a prover, he could have been arrested, and the CBI had obviously zeroed in on some point, which is why either he had to take his life because he did not want to betray his boss, somebody who he had served for many years, either he didn't want to do that, or he was too afraid that he would be forced to reveal something or turn a prover. So all these dilemmas could have led to whatever happened in Chennai this morning. Either he was removed or he took his own life. So I think Mr. Sadiq Basha's death is a big setback, because some loose ends are obviously remain to be tied up.
Well, that's the 1,76,000 crore rupee question to which we'll never have the answer. What would Sadiq Basha have told the CBI interrogators when he would have met them this evening? Would he have turned a prover? We would have known by now had he been alive. But in his death, we can only hope that the truth finally emerges. Since the Time headlines today broke the Raja Radia tapes, the people of India have been appalled by the length of deprivation that this case brings out. Let's just hope the truth emerges. On that note, Paranjoy Guhathakurta, Sandeep Bamzai, Mr. Krishna Anand, Subramaniam Swami and Chandan Mitra, thank you very much for joining us on the Center Stage Face-Off this evening.